Now, why is LIN considered in most vehicles today and not replaced with any of these protocols? To answer this question, focus should again be brought back to the question on why was LIN developed in the first place. LIN, abbreviated as Local Interconnect Network, is a serial network protocol used for communication between components in vehicles. If you have followed my videos, you might know that we have CAN, CAN-FD and then FlexRay to fulfill the needs of communication protocol in vehicle. Now, why is LIN considered in most vehicles today and not replaced with any of these protocols? To answer this question, focus should again be brought back to the question on why was LIN developed in the first place? What was going on in the minds of developers when they developed LIN protocol? LIN came into existence in the time frame when CAN was most common protocol used in car. In that time frame, car manufacturers were in need of a protocol which was cheaper compared to CAN, with the trade-off of the protocol being slower than CAN. They felt that everything inside the car was not required to be communicated in the speed of CAN protocol, and instead can be managed by a lower speed protocol for less time critical messages without any extreme fault tolerance. So in late 1990s, the LIN consortium was founded by five auto manufacturers, namely BMW, Volkswagen, Audi, Volvo, and Mercedes-Benz, with technologies supplied, that is networking and hardware expertise, from Volcano Automotive Groups and Motorola. Then in November 2002, fully implemented version of new LIN specification was published. In September 2003, version 2.0 was introduced to expand capabilities and make provision for additional diagnostic features. In 2010, LIN 2.2a was released, which is currently used version. Then in 2016, CAN in automation standardized LIN as ISO standard with ISO 17987. Now if we compare LIN and CAN, LIN is less costlier than CAN. LIN uses single 12 volt wire while CAN uses twisted shielded 5 volt dual wires. LIN is deterministic, not event driven, while CAN, as you know, is event driven. LIN clusters have single master, while CAN, as you know, has multiple masters. LIN uses 6-bit identifier, while CAN uses 11 or 29-bit identifier. Lastly, LIN offers max 20 kilobits speed, while CAN offers up to 1 megabit speed. So now let's understand LIN in a bit more detail. LIN usually is placed in a master-slave network. In LIN network, the master node loops through each of the slave node by sending request for information, and slave node will then respond with data when master node pulls them. Before we dive in, let's understand LIN frame format. LIN bus message frame consists of a header and a response. Typically, in a LIN network, the LIN master sends a header in the LIN bus and the slave responds with a response of 8 data bytes. Considering the LIN header consists of sync break field, sync field, and identifier followed by 2 parity bits. Sync break field, also called as SBF, is of 14 plus bits, most often 20 bits long. The field acts as a start of frame indicator to all the LIN nodes on bus. Sync field is 8 bit long with a predefined value of hex 55 so that the LIN slave nodes gets to know that the baud rate used by master node with the rising and the falling edge of this field. Identifier field is 6 bits long, used to identify the node that has to react to the LIN header. The validity of LIN header identifier field is determined by parity bits. Based on the above header, LIN slave node would either ignore the request and subsequent data transmission, listen to the data sent by other node, or publish data in response to the header. Basically, one slave is polled for information at a time by the master. Hence, there is zero collision risk and, of course, no need of arbitration. Slave response consists of two fields, the data field and the checksum. Data field. Data field consists of slave response to master by transmission of 2, 4 or 8 bytes of data. Data length is customizable, but typically it's linked to the identifier. For example, slave with identifier from 0 to 31 sends 2 bytes, from 32 to 47 will send 4 bytes, and from 48 to 63 will send 8 bytes. Data byte contains actual information that the LIN node wants to communicate to master. Checksum field ensures the validity of the LIN frame. So let's look at different frame types that exist in LIN network. Unconditional frame. The unconditional frame is a default form of communication where master sends a header and relevant slave responds with specific information. Event-triggered frame. This frame is sent when master polls multiple slave and slave responds if its data has been updated with identifier in first data byte. Sporadic frame. This frame is sent by master when it has to communicate updated data to specific slave node. Here master acts as a slave and responds to its own header by letting the slave node get dynamic data. Diagnostic frame. Identifier from 60 to 61 are used for reading diagnostics from master or slave. Frames always contain 8 bytes of data. ID 60 is used for master request and 61 for slave response. User-defined frame. User-defined frame may contain any type of information. Specifically, identifier 62 is used for this frame. So with this, we have covered the basics of LIN, covering significance of LIN, LIN history, LIN versus CAN, LIN frame format, and lastly, LIN frame types.